Welcome to Cell Signaling Technology, a company devoted to fueling the quest for scientific discovery.
If you're looking for a work culture that's rooted in collaboration, innovation, creativity, and community, you'll find that here.
We asked two of our colleagues, Laurel and Shrikant, what's a typical day like for a product scientist at CSD?
Let's find out.
Every day, typically, I run Western blots in order to test the products that I'm making and make sure that we have lot-to-lot consistency. I also always log into my tech phone and log into Salesforce to pick up technical support cases to help our customers troubleshoot when they're having difficulty with their experiments. And I also usually pick up custom orders and custom lots that need to be made to help with the custom production.
So I fill my day with experiments at the bench, usually Western blot, some IPs, tissue culture downstairs. We do some dot blots, and that's throughout the day. The targets you work on, it varies, but then we also sprinkle that in with technical support.
Coming from academia into industry, we have a lot of different systems that we use and SOPs to follow, and it was definitely a lot to learn. But what I really enjoy now is that now that I know all of the systems that we use, I've become really involved in process improvement and looking at how we do things and figuring out ways to do things more efficiently or make things easier, more user-friendly. I've really enjoyed being a part of, improving our processes here.
So most directly, a product scientist interacts with development scientists, but I also like to interact with people in marketing, people in sales, research scientists. So we're trying to come up with a way to bring new targets to CST that would help not only internally, but also be valuable to customers that in their own research.
At this time, you do not need to have a PhD to be a product scientist. It's really important to have a good scientific background and to have some pathway knowledge, but we do hire at different levels, so you can come in without a PhD.
So it's a sense of pride. You feel like you're contributing to science, contributing to the community, and you're doing your part to help other people do their job to hopefully one day find treatments and cures for all these diseases that are affecting so many loved ones in our lives.